welcome y'all back tonight, so this is our, who knows how many annual event we've had. Most of the white children were not born yet when we started this, so.
White folks.
No. We've had some other things.
We had cantatas and things.
Yeah.
The variety show, I think, started maybe right after Christmas, so. We're gonna start with a whole group of people, Horsey, Jessica, Steffi, and the kids doing Lion Sleeps tonight.
That's yours.
Watch the candles.
Watch the candles.
Tim, back them up and look.
Back.
You're too close to that.
I mean.
The Lion Nation is covered tonight.
Oh my gosh.
I did see no tinsel, no presents, not even a tree.
Under the stocking by the mantel, just boots filled with sand. Or the wall hung pictures of far distant lands. With metal and badges, awards of all kinds, a silver thought came to my mind. For this house was different, it was dark and dreary. I found the home of a soldier once I could see clearly. The soldier lay sleeping, silent, alone, curled up on the floor in this one-bedroom home. The face was so gentle, the room in such disorder. Not how I had pictured a United States soldier. Was this the hero whom I just read, curled up on a poncho to the floor for a bed? I realized the families that I saw this night owed their lives to those soldiers who were willing to fight. Soon around the world, children would play and the grown-ups would celebrate a bright Christmas day. They all enjoyed freedom each month of the year because of soldiers like the one lying here. I couldn't help wonder how many lay alone on a cold Christmas Eve in a land far from home. The very thought brought a tear to my eye. I dropped to my knees and started to cry. The soldier awakened, and I heard an above voice. Santa, don't cry. This is my life. It's my choice. I fight for freedom. I don't ask for more. My life is my God, my country, my corpse. The soldier rolled over and drifted to sleep. I couldn't control it. I continued to weep. I kept watch for hours, so silent, so still. And we both shivered from the cold night's chill. I didn't want to leave on this cold, dark night. This guardian honor so willing to fight. The soldier rolled over and with a soft voice and pure whisper, carry on, Santa. It's Christmas Day. All secure.
Jessica's going to stand with the piano. She's going to be one of my favorites, Carol Bells.
I don't know the order of service, so I'm just sitting here.
It's all good. It's okay.
Okay.
Good job, Christopher. Thank you. Make us cry.
Piano, all the same day.
of Tim, I'll be home for Christmas.
How many of y'all like crabs?
Yeah.
This will make you hungry for crabs. She should be the girl by herself. You know, it's worth the wait.
This is recorded, right?
Department store north of Houston, Santa Santa Claus on Christmas Eve. In a moment he knows the front door will close, and this tired old Santa can pack up and leave. But a big fella came out of nowhere, and he sat right down on Santa's knee. Well, the whole place stopped there, as the big fella said, "Dear Santa, I appreciate you listening to me." And he said, "Oh, I want crabs for Christmas. Oh, only crabs will do. Oh, only crabs for Christmas. My Christmas wishes come true." Well, that Santa, he started perspiring, and he looked like he might be in pain, and his face got all stiff as he asked the man if he would take a moment and kindly explain. Well, the man said, "You know, I'm from Maryland, and them crabs is what I'm itching for. Don't you know, Santa dear, with steamed crabs and a beer, it would be like a trip back to old Baltimore. Baltimore. Oh, I want crabs for Christmas. Oh, only crabs will do. Oh, and with crabs for Christmas, my Christmas whistle come true." Round that corner came two big policemen, and they saw that man on Santa's lap. Well, they reached for his throat and his bowling league coat, and they picked him up, losing his Oreo cap. Santa cried, "Put him down right this instant. Now, my boy, would you want not so odd? But there's no crabs to make, so we'll hop in my sleigh. We'll fly to New England and I'll give you scrun." "No, not scrun. Oh, I want crabs for Christmas. Oh, only crabs will do. Oh, and with crabs for Christmas, my Christmas wishes come true. Oh, I want crabs for Christmas. Oh, crabs will do. Oh, and with crabs for Christmas, my Christmas whistle, my Christmas whistle, my Christmas whistle.
What's that?
Hey, Ron, don't you know that's my Christmas whistle? My Christmas whistle come true.
Tonight have been pretty happy songs. I'm here to put them into that. May seem inappropriate in some ways to sing the song, but it's very appropriate in other ways. So. Thank you. Mentions the son a lot, S-U-N. I think if you change that to S-O-N, the song makes a lot more sense.
Moving on, 'cause there's a
No, I'm not hungry.
I do have an announcement. You know, a lot of the work that we do on stage, there is one person that pulls it all together. So, Steffi, for you, thank you for all the events.
We doubled our salary.
We doubled our salary.
We just doubled our salary.
We doubled our salary for next year.
We were trying for triple, but Travis wouldn't let us.
I'm a miser.
I'm not playing anything else.
So we have no volunteers. Why don't I say a prayer and then we'll pray for the food and we'll go over there and have some fellowship.
I think we're supposed to have a special guest.
Oh.
Yeah.
Is he coming to the lunch?
He's at the door.
Oh, okay.
I mean, not the lunch,
though. Yeah,
he's here. Ho, ho, ho! Merry Christmas, everybody!
Merry Christmas.
How are y'all doing?
Good.
We want crab.
There's no crabs till May. Alrighty, Merry Christmas!
Alright, let's pray. Heavenly Father, we thank you for this evening. We can come together in your house, Father, just for a night of some fun and listen to some music. Hopefully it was worshipful to you. Be with each and every one of us as we go home tonight and bring us back to the next appointed time. Father, we thank you for the food that we're about to have next door and continue the fellowship and the fun with each other. It's in your Son's name that we pray.
Amen.